Hello everybody. So I thought I would kind of make a sit down informal vibe of a video about some camera lenses that I have been using recently that I'm actually surprised I use. When I initially bought my FX3, I had been previously working on the Blackmagic system. So I had all Canon EF mount lenses. So I actually sold that entire set, mostly because I had bought those for a Micro Four Thirds system. And so they just didn't seem like they were worth keeping. But what I knew I wanted to buy when I got my FX3, because I was on a budget at the time, and I still somewhat am, of course, was the Sigma 24-70 2.8. I was going back and forth between the Sigma versus the Sony, but I went with the Sigma for the price point, and I knew I really just needed a lens to get started and so that I could be booking gigs and have like the full ecosystem. I already had all my audio gear, I had everything else that I really needed, so I just needed one really compatible lens, and the 24-70 did that for me. Before I bought the FX3, I never owned a 24-70. I thought they were a pretty vanilla lens, pretty boring. But I'm actually really happy that I did buy that lens. It really got me started on a good foot. As a second lens that I added to the kit was the Sony 16-35 F4 Power Zoom. I actually bought this lens used off of Facebook Marketplace from a guy who bought an Amazon lot where you basically like bid on it, and he opened the lot and there was 10 of these 16-35 brand new. That story checked out. I made sure to check it out before I purchased from him. So I got it for a few hundred dollars less than brand new and zero tax, which was cool. And then after that, a few months later, I bought the Sony 70-300 4.5-5.6, I believe. Super happy with that lens. Ultimately, I always thought, oh, I never would use a 70-200. And it's true. I think a 70-200 is like just almost what you need. So the 70-300, I was able to pick up for around $600 used as well. And that lens has blown my mind with how absolutely sharp it is. And I'm just so happy that I purchased that lens and that I have it in my kit. So I have a 16-35, a 24-70, and a 70-300. So like all of my bases are covered. But then I decided, well, you know, I'm missing out on like a super wide angle, and I wanted to do some creative shots that were pushing more towards a fisheye, but I of course did not want to spend a lot of money on that. So that is when I bought the TT Artisans 11mm 2.8 lens. This is a fully metal build lens. It is completely manual, but honestly, I'm so happy with it. I love the look of it. You throw some like vintage, nice color grading on there, and that thing is a vibe. It gives you a really cool look, and it's useful to kind of break up like your certain kind of clips when you're creating different kind of, you know, styles and stuff. And so I'm really happy with it. I'll throw it into specific, very specific, more creative shoots when I want to bring in some kind of just different looks. Definitely not a lens you're going to be bringing anywhere on a corporate set or anything like that. I mean, it depends, but what blew me away with the 11mm is how insane the minimum focus distance is on that lens. It is crazy. It's 0.17, which is just like mind-blowing. I don't own a lens with that good of a minimum focus distance other than that one. So then after my 11mm, I was like, cool, I knocked off the fisheye, you know, funky creative look, and I can achieve these like really cool shots. But now I kind of want to go back to like my vintage camera roots, which I used to when I was like around 14. I got super interested in collecting vintage cameras. At one point, I think I had like 40 plus cameras and lenses and all these things. And I would go to these camera swap meets and trade and sell and all that good stuff. Ended up selling a lot of those cameras and lenses, but I did hold on to my dad's Minolta SRT-101, which was a camera I shot rolls and rolls of film on, and the 50mm 1.7. So I started shooting on my FX3 with the 50 1.7, absolutely loved it, like fell in love. And that's when I started looking into the Contax Carl Zeiss lenses, who had seen on YouTube like other filmmakers using, and I was like, you know, these, like, I like the character of them because they're not too absurd. I also years back had bought the Helios 442, and to be honest, I just feel like the Helios 442 just has like too much character. I know that they filmed Batman with it and all that cool stuff, but maybe the make I got, because they're all like so weirdly different, there's no fungus in there. It's a great build. It's just like, it's just too much character. I don't know how to explain it. And you know, you would use that on like a very specific use case. And I wanted vintage lenses that I could shoot when I just want that bit of like warmth and character to the scene. And so that's why I picked up the Contax Carl Zeiss 25, 35, and 100 millimeter macro. I needed a macro lens because I didn't own one in my kit, and I thought it'd be fun to buy a part of the kit because ultimately when you're doing macro, you're typically doing manual focus anyways, and I like the idea of bringing kind of that character even to the macro shots. 25-2.8 is definitely my favorite lens out of the three so far. I'm planning to probably add a 50 and 85. Right now when I need a 50 and at a 1.7, I'll shoot on the Minolta Rockor lens that I have, and I honestly love it. It's just I think it'd be good to have like a complete Contax Zeiss kit to rent out locally and also to just like have and own as time goes on, because I think the value could grow in those. Who knows? The 35 millimeter is of course kind of your standard 35. She doesn't quit, she always performs, she looks good. And I really like it. I think it's really useful, especially to just like carry around and have for that just like 10 millimeters more. It actually does make a massive difference. And having a 35 2.8 is really nice. That isn't a part of my 24-70 Sigma. That thing is massive. So it's really nice because the 35 is so extremely small, as you can see. So big, big fan of that. I ended up modding out all of these Contax Zeiss lenses with the Samod or Samode lens. You can check them out on their website, samodlens.com. And one of the Cine converters that they sent me was actually faulty, so I'm waiting on them to send me that so that I can get this one rigged out. And so for now, I'm just waiting on it. And some really fun thing that happened is I ordered the 100 millimeter macro off of eBay, as I did with all the others. And I don't think the buyer knew that there was a Contax Y mount to Sony E mount, which is freaking awesome because the 100 millimeter macro, Samod Lens does not make a Cine converter for the back four. So I was waiting for it to come from this one person who makes them in Europe. And it's so cool because I get to use this one, even though the mount isn't here yet, because they accidentally sent me this, which is really cool. So I've been doing a lot of test shots and having a really fun time with this lens. I'd say the 100 millimeter is in the best shape out of all these lenses I got. It's like completely flawless and just a really, really like chunky, beefy, awesome lens. And I just love it. So really, really happy with this decision. And ultimately, yeah, so it's a bit of like, you know, a funny kit, like all these random lenses. But for me, it's something that I really, really like. And I know that the Contax Zeiss lenses have just as much their own little niche as that 11 millimeter fisheye does. And then all of my automatic lenses, my 16-35, 24-70, and 70-300, pretty much cover all corporate or interview needs or kind of being run and gun on the go. But then the Contax Zeiss and everything else kind of bring in and help me with that creative side of things. So I think the 25 millimeter Contax Zeiss I'll probably be putting to the most use. And I can see myself using on a lot of like B-roll shoots out and about outside doing like really fun stuff. So yeah, just wanted to share a little bit about the lenses I've been using, the kit I've built out over having the FX3 for I think over a year now, and really, really happy with this camera. I do play with the idea of getting an Ursa 12K because I love Blackmagic, and I shot on that for a few years with the Pocket Cinema camera. So potentially thinking about going back there, you know, one day soon, but we'll see where things go. But yeah, I hope you guys are doing well. Thanks for checking out this video, and I'll see you guys soon. Peace.